Okay, we are just about set to go now. Our flight plan over the canyon has been entered into the Garmin GTN 750. The complete flight plan is listed in the video description. I have completed the checklists. The heading bug has been set to the runway heading of 210. Flaps are set for 1/3 for takeoff. Prop levers are full forward, high RPM, and the mixture is full rich for both engines. One last breath of that clean cannon air. Full throttle, here we go. We'll be right back. at about 70 to 75 knots and gently lift the nose wheel. Turning on the autopilot and activating the heading mode. We are climbing out at about 1,000 feet per minute. The red area of the terrain warning is showing us the Vermilion Cliffs on the right-hand side of the aircraft. Now switching over to nav mode to intercept the first leg of our flight plan. There are specific altitudes through the corridors to maintain aircraft separation. Northbound flights are at 11.5 or 13.5 and southbound at 10.5 or 12,500 feet. We are now entering the Zuni Point corridor. The highlight of the Zuni Point corridor is a series of summits named after Greek and Roman gods and goddesses. Coming up first, we have Juno, goddess of marriage, followed by Jupiter, god of the sky, then of course Venus, goddess of love, and last but not least, Apollo, god of the sun. Here are the four temples viewed by Google Earth. looks like we have traffic about 12 miles off the right side of the aircraft, and that plane is way below 14,500 feet. We are now closing in on the south rim of the Zuni Point corridor. The Zuni Point lookout is unique, as you can view the Colorado River turning from a north-south direction to an east-west direction.
The California condor is a remarkable bird that was once pushed to the brink of extinction. What this bird lacks in looks, it makes up in its majestic flight. Only 22 birds were known to exist in 1982, but thanks to captive breeding programs, more than 500 birds now exist. Of this population, more than 300 are in the wild free-flying population. The California condor is still one of the world's rarest birds and remains on the endangered species list. These birds live in California, Arizona, Utah, and Mexico. They are the largest flying North American land bird, and they live between 60 and 70 years. Condors prefer nest sites high on cliff ledges or caves on the face of the steep cliffs. The birds mate for life and produce one egg every 2 years. California condors have a complex social system. They share food and use a variety of body postures to communicate and maintain social hierarchies. With a wingspan of 9.5 feet, they can soar and ride thermals to 15,000 feet when searching for dead animals. They only feed on carrion such as deer or elk. With good thermals, the California condor can stay aloft for hours. Flights in excess of 150 miles in one day have been recorded. Despite efforts to recover this critically endangered species through captive breeding and release, preventable lead poisoning stands in the way. Lead ammunition is the primary cause of lead poisoning in condors. Programs are now in place to use copper in place of lead ammunition to avoid lead poisoning death.
Many thanks to my guest narrator for that wonderful California condor story. We have picked up some ground speed with the tailwind on the home stretch. Straightforward RNAV procedure for landing. We will be at 9,000 feet crossing Carms and then descend to 8,200 feet at Hapley. From Hapley, I will disengage the autopilot and bring us in. Thank you. today. And remember, if you like this content, please do consider a subscription.